In this demo, we will show you how to organize collaboration on a project in the dedicated database development mode, how to use branches to isolate development tasks and then merge those branches, and how to resolve conflicts if two developers make changes to the same object. Let's consider the case where one of the developers, let's call them developer A, has already connected their local database to the main repository. As you can see, the refresh operation does not show any differences, which means that all database objects have already been committed to the main branch and the databases are identical. At the same time, another developer, developer B, wants to make some changes to the database in a separate branch. To do this, our second developer creates a local folder to store SQL files, goes to GitHub, creates a new dev branch based on the main branch, and clones the Git repository to the local folder. Developer B has not yet created a local development database and does this with the help of the wizard. As you can see, the newly created database is empty. Now, Developer B needs to link their empty database to the repository. Here we need to select the dev branch in Git and set the dedicated database development model because our developer B wants to work on their own copy of the database. The dev branch is a clone of the main branch. Since the database created by developer B is empty, we need to pull the database objects from the repository to the database. We select all objects and click Get Latest. Technically, dbForge source control executes object scripts located in the local repository folder against the Bicycle Store Dev database with dependency awareness. After an automatic refresh, you see that there are no changes in the objects, which means that our second developer's database and the repository are identical. Let's say developer B needs to add extra information on customers, like their Skype addresses. So they add a new column to the customer table and save changes to the database. Now let's return to the source control manager and click refresh. We see a new table has appeared in the local changes. Let's commit the changes. By the way, when you click commit, source control not only commits changes, but also performs the push operation. Now let's take a look at how to move a commit from the dev branch to the main branch via a pull request. To do that, go to Git. Open the source control demo folder, click pull requests, and then hit new pull request. Our direction is from dev branch to main. Click create pull request. One more time, create pull request. Then merge pull request. And finally, confirm merge. Now the main branch and the dev branch are identical. Next, let's look at the collaborative work with the help of dbForge source control and how the tool helps resolve conflicts. Suppose that developer A, who works with a local database that is linked to the main branch, wants to alter the customer table by adding the Skype column too. When developer A clicks the refresh button, dbForge source control pulls changes from the main branch and detects changes made to the same table by developer B. As we see, these changes are qualified as conflicting. To resolve this conflict, developer A needs to choose whose changes to apply. Let's choose to get local changes. The conflict is resolved. By clicking the commit button, the first developer pushes their changes to the main branch. You can see that now the main branch and developer A's local database are identical. The changes made by developer B have been overwritten. Download a free 30-day trial of dbForge source control and see for yourself that collaborative database development can be convenient and transparent.